Yes, our guest today is very beautiful, very talented. She's a singer, songwriter, and she goes by one name, like Beyonce. I'm talking about none other than Achieng.
Yes, karibu sana.
Asante sana.
How's you doing?
I'm good.
You look
I'm
gorgeous. Good.
Thank you very
your
much.
Your melanin is just popping, you? Man. It like even looks better from like here. If you were here, you would be seeing it.
But just to start off, so for the guys who are maybe seeing you for the very first time, mm-hmm. who is Achieng?
Achieng mm-hmm. is a singer-songwriter, mm-hmm. a lover of music mm-hmm. and expression, yani. Yeah. That's all I live for.
Yeah. Yeah. And where did your love for music begin from? Can you trace
Ototoni.
It back?
Ototoni.
Oh, for real?
Ototoni.
You're those people who could sing before you could walk.
Well, I don't know about that part.
But,
but mm-hmm. Tangu niwe mtoto, I've mm-hmm. been listening to music. Mm-hmm. I've been introduced to music mm-hmm. by my family. Okay. I heard you guys are talking about like toxic family.
Yeah.
I guess mine was very, very musical.
Oh, that's yeah. nice. So yeah. Was it like everyone in like the family, or was it like particular like relatives?
More like everyone in the family, because
oh,
kila
so
mtu
nice.
Alikuwa ana consume. Mm-hmm. Yeah, and there was freedom to just get your own sound. You
nice.
Know, if you're listening to reggae, fine.
Yeah.
If you're listening to R&B, mm-hmm. okay.
Nice.
If you're listening to rumba, mm-hmm. that was my grandpa especially.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
Oh. So it wasn't actually like in church. It was like an everyday thing. Like the music was like an everyday thing. Because you know, most there are a lot of stories of people who started in church because mm-hmm. that's where they used to sing and like
yeah.
hear music. For you, it was in the house. Like
for me, music was in the house.
Wow.
Yeah, in the house.
That's beautiful. That's yeah. really
and
beautiful.
How did that, you know, impact you when it came to you choosing to pursue music and the particular genre that you'd pursue in your mm-hmm. future?
It wasn't such a foreign concept for me mm-hmm. when I figured this is the career path I want to follow, because mm-hmm. we already had these conversations like with my grandpa, with my mom. Mm-hmm. She's like, you know, you can actually make money out of music.
Mm-hmm.
So when I finally decided this is what I want, it didn't seem like such a strange thing. Like now I have to start from zero
yeah.
and figure out, do I have to be a broke artist
yeah.
for how long?
Because
yeah.
it's natural.
Yeah.
Yeah. And you've mentioned some of like the musical influences in like in your household when you were growing up. So you must have some very interesting influences in general. So
yes,
is
I
there
guess so.
A particular person, a particular genre that is your inspiration or like your, yeah?
I have no specific genre. Mm-hmm. I like to genre bend because
mm-hmm.
music is so wide. It's
yeah.
it's big.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, so I feel like if I focus on just one thing,
mm-hmm.
I'd be limiting myself.
Nice.
In terms of the artists
mm-hmm.
who've heavily influenced me,
mm-hmm.
whew, there's Asha. Asha, she's a Nigerian musician,
okay.
Nigerian born, based in France right now.
Oh, nice.
I love her writing.
Mm-hmm.
Yani, it's so personal,
mm-hmm.
and that's how I've always wanted to put
does
my work out.
Does she write in French?
Does she write in French? I don't know.
Oh, okay,
but she speaks French.
Okay, okay.
She writes a lot of Yoruba.
Oh, right.
In English.
Okay, 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 nice.
Yeah,
mm-hmm.
that's
what
just one of them.
Yeah.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
So, what are some of the? What would you say your sound is? Since you're, you know, you don't mind any genre of
yeah.
music, but what's your sound, or what's your favorite sound?
I'd say the foundation of it mm-hmm. is like folk reggae soul,
because
mm-hmm. I really like the element of storytelling,
mm-hmm.
hence folk.
Mm-hmm.
And reggae and soul, I feel like all music just
yeah.
comes from soul, really, because
mm-hmm.
mm-hmm. you're sharing a piece of you. Atakama,
yeah.
it's a club song, it's
exactly,
still a piece of you, you
exactly.
know. Yeah, I'd put that as my foundation, but yeah, I'm just a genre bender, honestly. Ukinyeka
mm-hmm.
anywhere, I just want to feel like I'm bringing
you'll
the Achiengness into it.
Yeah.
Okay,
yeah.
7 years down the line, how many songs
yeah.
so far?
Oh, man, I can't count.
So many songs, albums, EPs.
Not released yet, because
uh-huh.
my focus initially was in performance.
Okay.
And then, man, Corona happened.
That's
and
true, yeah.
the stages were all shut, and I was like, yeah, you know what?
Yeah.
This is now the time to start recording. So
mm-hmm.
now is when I'm bringing out
mm-hmm.
the Izo, my MVs and minis
uh-huh.
of music that
mm-hmm.
I've been writing over the years.
So you used to
oh,
do
wow.
live performance?
Yes,
on
I
stage?
Used to.
Okay, you
still
do
still
it?
Do. I still do.
Weddings, events, people can invite you.
Yeah.
Or
do you know, the weirdest thing
uh-huh.
is I've never played a wedding.
You've never
really?
Played, but would you want
no,
to?
No, I haven't. I would.
Why?
You'd consider
you
it?
Yeah.
I feel like...
You're not sure?
Do you
uh-huh.
not want to
not
go to a wedding?
Not really.
Uh-huh.
I just feel like, you know, I don't want to come to your wedding and sing and make you guys happy and then like... a year down the line, you're divorced.
Oh, damn. Okay, okay. That's a good point.
Yeah,
that's
but... That's a really good point. Yeah, if you guys are looking into getting married soon, just hit me up.
Cool. I'll do a cool set
for you.
So do you remember your first, like, professional song?
My first professional song?
Mm-hmm. The one that you put out as an artist, like a chain, like the artist.
Oh my god. It? Yeah, I do.
Do you remember the words? I want to sing for us a bit to hear your voice.
Oh my god. Guy Aki ilikuwa kitambo.
You don't remember it?
No, I remember it. Mm-hmm. I remember it. Mm-hmm. It's called Kemet Nu.
Is that Kibu?
Is that Kijaluo? Walai,
it just sounds Swahili.
Imagine it's not.
What is it?
Oh my god. It's like old Egyptian, it means know yourself.
Oh,
Egypt. Yeah. So okay, cool. At Egypt.
What? Egyptian.
It's Egyptian.
Mm. No, it's not. Just the name.
Okay.
Just the name.
Okay.
Just the name.
Okay. Okay. Why did you go all the way to Cairo?
Cairo.
You're welcome.
Here on Chatbot, we aspire to inspire.
Exactly.
What happened? Why did you particularly choose for your first song?
Because at that time, I was in a space where I was trying to figure myself out.
Mm-hmm.
Like, outside of school, I just finished school and, you know, like, there's this whole identity crisis, ukiwa shule, and then now ukonja shule, and everyone expects you to be this adult that knows what they want and how they want to go about it.
Mm.
And honestly, I didn't. I didn't know how to go about it.
You had no plan.
I had no idea. I had a plan, though.
Okay.
But, you know, like, something as simple as taxes, that thing still scares me.
Bro.
But, you know, you're expected to come out of high school and
know how to do it.
Yeah.
That makes sense. Yeah.
Yeah, so ilinipata at that time when I was just figuring myself out.
Uh-huh.
And... yeah, I was questioning a lot of things, like, about myself, about how I identify, about even my name. Like, I do not use my English name.
That's true.
It will never come up.
Yeah.
Yeah, and I realized, you know, the best way for me to make this way, like, me finding my way easy, is just to focus on, like, the basics. I'm an African.
Mm-hmm.
I can never outrun that.
Yeah.
So... of course, like, ukianza kwa hiyo journey, the most prolific, I don't know, like, the most information you can find that's very out there is just on Egyptian history.
That's true.
Ours was stolen from us, it was hidden. Yeah. It's deep down under so many religious texts.
You have to look so far.
You have to look so far to find it.
Mm-hmm.
So I found that and I was like, yeah, Kemet Nu looks like something I can.
That is so cool, man. So how's your journey been so far, especially as a female in the industry? I know we bring it up a lot, but hello, we're all girls on this table.
We're all girls.
And it's harder for us as women.
You're
but
right,
yeah,
you're
how's
so right.
How's your journey been as a female?
It's not been easy.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. I know most women will say that because that's the, it's a sad truth.
Yeah.
It's not been easy. I've worked with producers who want to steal my work.
Oh,
and I'm just like, you know what? Achaika esta release.
No.
I've worked with guys who want to, like, you know, nipe kitu. And I'm like, I've already
in
paid
exchange
for studio fees.
Oh,
you
come
know,
on.
It's shady. It's really shady out
that
here.
Is so
but
shady.
That was when I was starting out.
Uh-huh.
And the good thing is, women really support each other.
Mm-hmm.
Women really do support each other. Mm-hmm. So the female friends I made it easy. Like, you want to record? Let me give you a producer I know who's stuck on work, not at you. Utakuja kuambiwa ukue second wife wa wapi. And I'm just here to do a verse.
Okay, that's really
crazy.
Nice, guys.
Yeah.
All right, so guys, let's take a short commercial break. I know Achieng amehipa kuimba, but tukirudi anatuimbia by horse, by fire. We'll be right back. Achieng, ladies and gentlemen, with falling. It's so
are
catchy.
Are you in love with somebody? Did you fall?
Yeah,
are you,
in love?
Are you falling for somebody?
Then I was, are you single? Are you taken? Are you ready to?
Ambia boy chalu kuin jaki.
Mimi, I am married to the music.
I like it.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
So what inspired this song? Was it like other people's experiences?
No. Hey, this one was direct, personal. Very personal experience.
So you fell for someone they didn't catch.
No. Yo, kiwai fanyika, I think that song will probably hit like 100,000 views. Uh-huh.
Okay.
No, the song is actually a parody on how we hit on each other. Unajua wale watu wa hi, madam, hi, please. Yeah, and then how hawasemi kitu.
Yeah.
So I was like, you know what, let me just try and entertain these people and see how far this can go.
You said hi back.
I said hi back. Like, kwanza ile ilikuwa hi ya
hi.
I was like, hi, hi.
That means so much. Oh, God.
Yeah. Unajua mtu akiona chance. I guess, huyo mtu acha nisi ongeleje kila mtu. Huyo mtu aliona chance na ikakuwa tu zile very plastic lines. You know, if you say yes to me, I will fly you across the country. I will da 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 da. And I'm like, I don't know how naive you think I am, but I've done this before.
Yeah,
yeah, ilikuwa tu ku entertain.
So how far did you go with it?
How far did I go?
Yeah. Tell us.
Ilikuwa.
So you get the number, you're able to
never. Oh my God, I cannot let you break into my peace of mind. How do I put a number angu if I don't want you to have it?
Yeah.
No.
very
ilikuwa tu kwa DM, hapa ndo penye inaishia. Because, you know, the most I can do is block you.
That's my favorite thing to do.
I think I need to start checking my DMs. There's a pata, you know, inspiration.
Utapata high highs.
Hi, you got to hi.
For the ones who talk to themselves, hi.
You die.
Hi. I'm fine too. Hi. But so exhausting. What does it feel like to work with such a big artist while you're still, I don't want to say young.
Yeah.
But like young-ish in the industry. Like, how did that even come to be? Did you reach out to him? Did he reach out to you?
He's a good friend with the producer I was working with. Mm-hmm. He's called Provoke.
Mm-hmm.
And so Ali come studio, I think just to hang out or check on him.
Yeah.
Yeah, and he found the song playing.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And he was like, I like it.
He was like, I like this. Yeah. Yeah, so me nilikuwa nishaenda home. Like I wasn't in session.
Oh, so you were being told that he had it.
I was being told. Yeah. Actually nilitumiwa tu a voice note. And but wait, Achieng, you would listen to this, because I left the studio. We'd finished the song and we were like in a sound foopy. So what should we do? Should we make it longer? Should I write a rap on it? Should I instrumental? What should we do? So we're like, let's just give it some time to breathe. Man, it did not breathe, because King Kaka came and gave it more life.
So what are you looking forward to, you know, after Falling? Yeah. Well, what are you currently working on?
I'm actually done. Like, ku release too.
Oh, wow.
We're just
nice.
getting people ready.
Was the album Achieng?
Definitely. Definitely. Okay. There's an EP on the way.
Mm-hmm.
It was meant to be an album, but we figured, acha tupe watu pole pole.
Yeah.
I'm releasing a song next month. Mm-hmm. Yeah, we just want to keep people as engaged as possible, because as I said before, like my main avenue has been performing.
Mm-hmm.
So to record and to share means I'm reaching out to wider audiences. So just trying to stay consistent, you know, staki kutoa moja and then I dip.
You disappear, yeah.
Ikue, now we're starting from ground zero.
Nice, yeah. That's good. We're looking forward to it, definitely.
Yeah.
So what would you say has been your biggest achievement so far? Or maybe like top two, top three, what has been your biggest achievements or achievement?
Are you talking in terms of music or just generally life-wise?
Music, but also life-wise.
Music. Man, to be honest, my biggest achievement is that I'm still doing music.
Okay.
Because when the pandemic hit, I was in a state of panic. Mm-hmm. And I'm sure every other artist was feeling the same way.
Yeah.
Because, you know, the stages were shut.
Mm-hmm.
The studios were shut for a while.
Yeah.
And you're just like, Santa Fania.
What now? Yeah.
Like, should I go back to school and finish? Should I just take the next job that comes my way?
Mm-hmm.
And I was like, you know what? I've dedicated my life and my time to this. I've invested so much time. I don't want to just give up.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I feel like that's my greatest achievement, to keep pushing.
That's nice.
Yeah.
Okay, and I'm glad to your fans who love you and have been following you all through for the last 7 years. Mm-hmm. Speak to them.
Honestly, I have so much love for you guys. It's it's intense. Yeah. It's intense. Like iko hapa kwa hii chest space inatoka kwa roho. Yeah, like you know that's commitment. Mm-hmm. Nani commitment bila kuambia mtu like this is where we are going.
Yeah.
Like you're just sticking with me even when I'm silent, you're still there listening to Achieng stuff.
Mm-hmm.
Thank you so much, and yeah, your presence does not go unnoticed.
Oh, nice.
Yeah.
And like you have a very textured voice. I don't know if I should call it that. It's a very textured voice. So can you give us an a cappella? Say you happy, by the way. Whichever you want.
The very, very, very first song I released.
Take us to Egypt.
Yes, take us to Cairo.
Pole, pole mtoto. I've actually forgotten the song. there we go. Pole, pole mtoto, kobe hatimaye hufika. Pole, pole mtoto, wakati wako utafika.
Nice. Girl, you can sing.
Yeah, like it sounds so full. Oh, what is the song
it's
about?
So it's because like for most of my songs, I'm talking to myself. Okay. I feel like that's the best way anyone can relate. Because if you don't feel, like I believe what I'm saying, then why would you even press play on the song?
That is amazing. Yeah. So are we looking?
Okay.
Mm-hmm. Did you have to practice your voice to get it to where it is, or was it naturally
there? Oh yes, I did.
Okay.
Well, yeah, naturally.
It was there already.
Yeah, and when I figured this is what I want to do, I was like, yeah, let's make sure I'm singing until I'm 90.
Oh, that's
cool. Okay. And so, you know, what are some? Okay, who are some of the artists we're looking? You know, you're looking at to working with, maybe doing collabs with.
Oh.
And that excited you?
She just got excited.
Okay, let's go.
Yeah, because you know, right now, you know, when people say there's no music in Kenya, I feel like that's blasphemous.
Yeah.
Yeah, I'm looking forward to writing with Bien, please.
Okay.
Bien,
that's your camera, that's camera 5. Send him a message.
Bien,
yes.
I want to write a song with you.
Yes.
I want to write songs, actually. See, moja too.
Yeah, tell me when he can greet you. Go ahead.
My name is Achieng across all social media platforms, spelled ACH13NG with an apostrophe at the end.
Nice.
Yeah.
All right, and one last thing before now we close the show for real. What kept you going? Because like this corona period has been a month of despair for a lot of creatives. A lot of people have like, you know, committed suicide. A lot of people have just quit everything they're doing to begin with.
Yeah.
So what kept you going? What made you be like, okay, let me just continue doing what I'm doing?
What kept me going?
Yeah.
I have a 4-year-old.
Oh
yeah,
girl. Let me tell you, if you see this girl's stomach, me honestly, I don't understand.
Okay, I didn't see that one coming.
I don't understand.
Yeah,
I didn't see that one coming.
She's very musical.
Okay. Mm-hmm.
So she finally convinced us to get her to do piano classes,
nice.
To get her piano classes and voice classes.
Mm-hmm.
And when you have someone like that looking up to you, you don't want her to see you as a musician one day and as an accountant the next. And she's like, oh, so maybe I shouldn't be consistent in chasing after my dreams.
Nice.
Yeah, so she's the one who's kept me going.
Nice.
Like, I want her to see me get to Beyonce status. I want her to see me play in Nyayo Stadium, like Nijazeyo Stadium.
Yeah.
And she's there playing keys.
Oh,
you know.
That is so cool.
Yeah.
That is so cool. You know, I've been suffering from baby fever, so.
Oh my God.
It's just not in my
feet. Take your time.
It's
bro.
In
take
my chair.
Time.
Oh my, thank you so much for coming through.
Thank you
we
so
really
much
do
for
appreciate,
me.
You know, keep on doing what you're doing, you
Asante
know.
Sana.
Graces with your amazing vocals. Makama K, we've come to the end of the show, guys. Thank you so much for tuning in and for watching and for the feedback. We'll be seeing you tomorrow, same time, same place. Makama K, sending you nothing but God vibes. Bye bye.
Yay!